Hello, my fellow skateboarders, longboarders, and freelance skaters. Today we are going to make a video today, and I thought I was a little bored, and I was looking at the computer and was checking on the internet and everything. I felt like, okay, I'll go and show them the close-up view of the Puente longboard trucks, just because like. We saw some 3D model earlier in my computer, and now I happen to have a chance to own one of the reverse kingpin trucks. By the way, I did not mention it was a reverse kingpin truck in my earlier video, the unpacking video or unwrapping video, just because I'm going to tell that in this video. So this is the entire parts of the reverse kingpin truck, which I have disassembled and kept it in the order in the way it goes inside the base plate, which is supposed to be here. So I thought I'll explain in this video. Okay, so I have kept everything in the same order that it goes, and here is the T-tool. So this one is this end is for kingpin, removing and tightening the kingpin. This end is for the wheels. This end is for the hardware which you screw in the base plate to the longboard or skateboard. Okay, so kingpin, wheels, and the hardware. Okay, and this hex key is used for tightening the holding the hardware nut and tightening with this. Okay, so you remove and use it. So let's go by the order. These are two locking nuts for the wheels, which goes at the end of the hanger, and two speed washers, you know, both goes at each end of the wheel. This is the kingpin nut. You can see the size difference. Kingpin nut is bigger than the locking wheel nut. Then goes the cone bushings. So cone bushings, these pink bushings are of special color. Why it is in pink transparent color? It's because like these specify a hardness value of higher hardness value. I have mentioned like 100A in the previous video. What I was trying to say is it is close to 100A hardness, which is like 96-97A kind of hardness. Okay, so this should be around 96-97A hardness, close to 100A hardness. Okay, so that's what the pink transparent color of any bushing does signify. This next goes the cone bushing and the cup washer for the cone bushing. So this one sits on the top of cone bushing, so cup washer for the cone bushing. Then comes the hanger itself, and this hanger, as I told earlier, it can be reversed. It can be put in this way as well as this way. Okay, and then comes the barrel bushing. I must have been mentioning this as cylindrical bushings, forgive me, I was new to this and I'm still learning the terminologies. This one is called as barrel bushing. Okay, these ones have a inner dia of 10 mm, both of them. Okay, and next one is the cup washer for the barrel bushing, which goes in the bottom, and you have the base plate itself, and the base plate has the kingpin. Okay, this is the kingpin design, and you have the pivot cup. Okay, so the pivot is in the hanger, and the pivot looks like this. Okay, so that is it. Those are the parts of the reverse kingpin truck, which is the Zorbis Puente kingpin truck. Now let's assemble this. Okay, so guys, hope you don't mind you know, me doing in an awkward way, because like my tripod is getting way on the table, so you could might be seeing a couple of my tripod stands here, but hope you ignore and focus on these things and my hands. Okay, so now let's start assembling this complete setup. So let's have a recap. This is the base plate with an angle of 48 degrees. I will show you how it is 48 degrees in a couple of minutes. Okay, so I'm gonna go back and put some gimmick here through an app, and we will record it through a screen recorder. Okay, I'll come back in a second.
So the screen recording will start in a minute, and we are here with an app called Protractor from Google Play Store, so which will help us define the angle of this base plate. I suppose it goes to 48 degrees, I believe. So I'm trying to center as much as possible, and if I corner this to, this is like almost like 48 degrees. Forgive me, my hand is shaking and it's not holding it this properly, so it should be around 48 to 50 degrees. So that is the angle of this base plate. Okay, so should be around 50 degrees. All right, 48 to 50 degrees. So that's what I was trying to convey through this gimmick. So now after this, let's get back to the actual video. Okay. So guys, that was the base plate and base plate angle, and you have the kingpin here, and that is the pivot cup, as I told you earlier. So the first assembly goes here is the cup. I'm sorry, I shook the tripod. Cup washer of these barrel bushing or the cylindrical bushing. So first goes the cup washer, then goes the cylindrical bushing, then you take your hanger and assemble it. So actually every hanger goes with the name, you know, like it falls outside. So you put the pivot inside the pivot cup first, and then you rest the hanger happily. As you sit the pivot properly in the pivot cup, the hanger will also sit properly in on the barrel bushing. Okay, so this is how you seat your hanger properly. So when you go with it, this is the actual assembly, after which goes your cone bushings, then you put your cup washer for the cone bushing, which is for the top layer of the cup washer, I mean the smaller diameter of the cone, and you put your kingpin nut and tighten it. So this is the entire assembly of the truck with the hanger. Then you put the speed washers and tighten the wheels and everything. Okay, now we will see like how the hanger can be reversed for lower base plate angle, I mean like lower angle with the base plate. Like say now you have a certain angle with the hanger here, right? So which is like 48 to 50 degrees. Now you kind of lift the hanger like this out and you remove it. Now as you might have noted, that name was on the top. Now I am reversing the hanger. I'm just putting the hanger inside the pivot cup and dropping it down. So when you properly push it and drop it there, your hanger will seat properly. Now put your cone bushing, the cup, corresponding cup washer, cup washer for the cone bushing, then tighten your kingpin nut. Okay, now you can observe the angle of the hanger has come down comparatively. So maybe 2 to 3 degrees, which will definitely make a difference when you're going for downhill. Okay, I am not sure like if this Zorbis Puente reverse kingpin truck is designed to reverse your hanger, but I'm just showing in demonstration for you guys, like that's how it's done. Okay, so now you remove the cup washer, your cone bushing, and lift your hanger up and put that in the proper direction. And by the way, there is a bush inside the pivot cup as well. Normally you put some soap or some sort of oil or any sort of mild lubrication for the pivot cup to move smoothly inside the pivot cup. I mean for the pivot to move in freely inside the pivot cup, like when you steer your skateboard with the reverse kingpin truck. In goes the cone bushing, then the cup washer, you tighten the kingpin nut. Then you put the corresponding speed washers to the axle. These are 8mm axles. Then you put the nut, wheel locking nut, and lock the nut. Then you put the corresponding speed washers onto the other side and lock the wheel. Okay. So this is how you assemble your truck, and that's how you disassemble your truck. By the way, this is a reverse kingpin truck. Okay, how you can say this? Your pivot has the visible kingpin nut. Okay, so it's not falling behind. So it's not a standard kingpin truck. This is a reverse kingpin truck. Hope that was useful. So this is the Zorbas Puente reverse kingpin truck, a longboard truck. And you saw the measurements last time. It was between 240 to 250 mm, which is said to be like 7 inch. Okay. So the ordered skateboard deck is of 8 inch. So this should work properly. And I also checked this truck with my carver. We will do the assembly later in another video. By changing the CX trucks to the reverse kingpin truck from the regular Oxalo 540 carve board, longboard, we will do that in another video. But I just checked it, just placing it over the board, you know, like this truck is too big for my carver. So we will do that in another video. So hope you learned something from this video, like where and how you disassemble and assemble your reverse kingpin longboard truck. Peace out. For those who miss me from seeing me in the video, let me tell you hi once again. This is Krishnan, a fine art photographer who loves to skate. Peace out.